blessed.
Look at your other neighbor and say, I am richly blessed.
I am richly blessed.
Ooh, I like that. Y'all going to be a good class today. All right. I am so honored to be able to stand before you to minister in the gift, one of the gifts that the Lord has empowered me with over the years. I thank him for salvation. I thank him for being filled with the Holy Spirit. I thank him for all that I have been through in my lifespan, that I'm still here. Point to yourself and say, I'm still here.
I'm still here.
Such a time as this. All right. Did you know that? Did you know you were here for such a time as this?
Amen.
Come on, get live with me, because I'm live. The kid ain't dead. So. You live, you got to speak up. Say amen.
Amen.
All right, last time, we kind of finished up. We're working on finishing up lesson two. And if you just getting your books and you haven't had an opportunity to keep up, you can just go back, or you can, if you're unfamiliar with what's going on, you can call me and I will bring you up to date. You can call me at 913-742-2874 and I will bring you up to speed. I would go back over some more things, but in the interest of time, we have so many different lessons to get to, I won't do that today. Amen?
Amen.
So if you have your books, if anybody doesn't have one, anybody don't have one of these? Anybody got one? I don't know who this is. Who's this? Is this you? Anybody need one? Everybody got?
I put them out.
You did? All right. All right, so in the book on page, kind of like the last page, on page 12, actually we'll do 12, 13, and we'll jump off into lesson number three today. Amen?
Yeah.
And so let's start at the page, top of page 12, and we'll run through that. We're not going to say. And so incidentally, for those of you who haven't been able to attend, we've been talking about the foundation for your Christian life. And lesson number two, without going over in real, reviewing it in deep detail, it's talking about finding your foundation for Christian life. And when you find your foundation, first we talked about what a foundation was. And then we talked about finding your foundation. And see, a foundation is the word of God when it comes to believers. Say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Right now. Don't let me put you on the spot. I'm just kidding. So I welcome everybody here today in the name of Jesus. So a foundation is that which you build up on for your life. Amen.
Amen.
And so when you find a foundation, when you know what the foundation is, and then you find it doesn't make any difference how young you are, how I don't call people old because I'm the youngest one. And now y'all ain't gonna get that. How many young people in here now?
Woo!
Every one of you, raise up your hand. Every single one in here. I want to see every hand up in here. I got Jerry's. I'm raising hands for Jerry.
There you go, man.
Yeah. That's my brother. All right, so. It doesn't make any difference where you are in your lifespan in the natural realm. What makes a difference is where your age is, or your where you are in your lifespan in the kingdom. Say in the kingdom. Because what we're talking about, a foundation for your Christian life, or finding that in reality, is finding it in the kingdom. Because everything that we say and we do from our supernatural birth relates to the kingdom from there on. Amen. How many with me? Are you with me?
Amen.
And so if you're not doing things that relate to the kingdom, then you're not doing, you're out of order. You're out of, like they drive in California, they drive so fast, they'll give you a ticket if you drive too slow. and everybody's driving over the speed limit. If you're driving too slow, you can get your ticket, not the person to drive. So what am I saying? I'm saying that in the supernatural realm, you got to keep up and you got to drive in your own lane. Say amen.
Amen.
How many know in the natural, when you get out of your lane, when you're driving, you cause a wreck, right? But if you don't drive right or keep up in the supernatural realm, you're going to cause a wreck.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all didn't get that. I'm going to be myself today. Is that all right?
Yeah.
All right, so now, in the top of the page, it said, why is the resurrection of Jesus Christ so important? And if you look down at my answer, since Jesus has been declared to be Lord, we understand that he will one day rule the earth as well as judge the inhabitants. And from that's taken from, I took that from Acts 17, 30 and 31, and it indicates that Jesus had been recognized as both Lord and judge. Now, Jesus, did you need one?
I'm sharing.
You okay? Now, Jesus is Lord, and last time we talked about Lord comes from the Hebrew word, which means my master. Say, my master.
My master.
And he's also king, and he's a king, and we talked about that last time because he created all things. Amen.
Amen.
He created all things, and then the sub part of that, he owns everything.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
I'd rather be owned by the Lord than be owned by the devil. Y'all ain't gonna say amen to that, huh? Y'all ain't gonna say amen to that, huh?
Yeah.
All right. And so the answer to that is because the resurrection is so important, because if we don't accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, then we won't be resurrected the way that he planned for us to be resurrected. Resurrected means just raised up or roused up in the Hebrew. And so when you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you are raised up from your spiritual state or condition that you are in before you get saved. Say amen.
Yeah.
That's why we have to be. I talk to all the young folk, you know, don't give me the high five. You two, don't be playing. So when you're saved, before you're saved, you don't know what you're doing. And some of us, after we get saved, we don't know what we're doing.
Right.
Why? Because when we get saved, your spirit is recreated, born again. That's why we have to be saved, born again. But then, now when I say this, I ain't calling no names, so don't be offended. But see, when we get born again, our spirit is God dealt with our spirit. But then we got a mental problem. Let me get up here because I don't want y'all to throw no rocks at the kid. We got a mental problem. And you said, what are you talking about, Dr. Clark? Because our mind needs to be renewed. Because our spirit is taken care of, but God gave us the tools for us to do. In Romans 12, 1, 2, and 3, it said, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the brothers. And when I say brethren, let's talk about the sisters too. Say amen, sisters.
Amen.
Don't leave them out, okay? He said, I beseech you therefore, brethren and sisters, by the mercies or the compassions of God, that you got to do something about your body. You present your body as a what? Living sacrifice, holy and what? Acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service or spiritual act of worship. Say worship.
Worship.
You present your body. And then it says, be not conformed, or don't be patterned, don't go, don't think, don't act like the world thinks, like we do. Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Like we do.
Hello.
But be transformed or be changed by the renewing of your mind. Now that word renewing comes from the Hebrew word that means, I'm moving a little fast, so if I'm going too fast, you can slow me down. That word renewing, just like your spirit, by the renewing of your mind, just like your spirit is recreated or regenerated, so your soul, where your mind is, or where your thoughts, say thought life. Now, the reason why we're having so many problems, and even in building up our, finding our foundation of life, for Christian life or the Christian faith, this is where we have our problems at. In our thought life, say everything,
starts
with the thought life.
With the thought life.
And see, if you don't learn how to control your thought life,
that's right.
Oh, y'all ain't gonna work through it. If you don't know how to control what comes into your mindset, Because you can't think the same way you did in the world. But even though you're born again, spirit filled, tongue talking, Bible talking, faith walking, peace loving, vintage confessing, bought, blood washed, men and women of God, you still have a mental problem if your mind isn't renewed. What are you talking about, Dr. Clark? I'm glad you asked that question. Because in our soulish realm, that's where the devil is used. He's used to, before we got saved, he used to running our lives.
That's right.
You hear people talk about kill the flesh? Well, the flesh, when they're talking about the flesh in the Bible, they didn't translate that from the Hebrew, right? And they translated it, they said, oh, you got to kill the flesh. Well, the flesh is indicative of the body. Say body. And you can train the body to do whatever it wants to do. You can train the what? Or what else is it called? The thought what?
Life.
Say thought life.
Thought life.
So I want to get that into your cranium today, because it's not a natural. You're not changing your natural way, your natural mind. You're training the mind of your spirit, because your soul is a part. Your soul is a part of your inner man. Oh, yeah, I ain't gonna work with me. The Bible says that the natural man or the unspiritual man, he cannot understand the spiritual things of God because they're spiritually understood. Why? Because they don't make sense in the what? In the natural.
That's right.
That's why when you first started reading the Bible and studying the Bible, you said, this don't make sense.
Yeah.
I can't understand this. Because you're trying to understand it with the natural mind.
Mm-hmm.
See, man originally had the mind, okay, I'm going to say that, he had the mastermind of Christ before he fell in the garden.
Right.
So he went from revelation and discernment to information that he gathered through his flesh or his body, or I want you to get this word here. You can write that in your book. S-E-N-S-E-S. It's five of them. Five senses. You can't understand spiritual things or supernatural things with your natural senses. Say, but. Just like you have a natural body, you have a spiritual body. Just like you have natural five senses, you have spiritual five senses. And so what I'm talking about is as you're walking and learning how to walk by faith and not by sight, you quit walking like by things that you see. Because we're so naturally prone to judge people from the outer appearance. We look at them, we judge. They say don't judge a book by the cover.
Right.
Well, I said last time, God was never interested in your color. He was always interested in your character.
Yep.
He was never interested in your race, per se, from an ethnic point of view, but he was always interested in faith. So what does that mean? God, there's only one race to God, and that's the race of the kingdom people. So if you're born again, say, I'm a kingdom person.
I'm a kingdom.
In the now.
In the now.
Say, I walk by faith and not by sight. That's what I'm talking about, baby. Four times. Oh, yeah, I'm listening. All right. So the reason why the resurrection is so important, because it's part of your foundation for growing or maturing in your walk of life. Everything you do relates to the what? Say kingdom.
Kingdom.
Say it again. Kingdom.
Kingdom.
That irks me when people are getting up and they're not preaching about, they're preaching all kind of gospel. They're preaching the prosperity gospel. They're preaching this gospel. They're preaching that one of them said this morning, we don't have our own agenda. It's supposed to be God's agenda. Kingdom agenda is God's agenda. And it includes your prosperity.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, praise the Lord. All right, let's move on. And so the very fact that Jesus was raised from the dead, or he was the firstborn from the dead, it indicates that his place of lordship in all things. Jesus is Lord or master over everything. But watch this. Every word that you're speaking, if it lines up and agrees with his word, he's watching over your words to make sure your words come to pass.
That's right. Amen. I
received
that.
Did you get that?
Yep.
Why? I don't know about y'all, but I'm created in God's image and God's likeness. It's a spiritual image and it's a spiritual likeness.
Amen.
You're not in the devil. You don't have the devil's nature. You know, people always say, well, you got two natures. No, you ain't. Your nature is not in your flesh. Your nature is in your spirit.
Amen.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
four times.
Woo-woo-woo.
Did you get that, sister? She said, your nature's not in your flesh. The flesh don't have a nature. Amen. You can turn to on your own. You don't have to turn to it now. Ezekiel, Holy Spirit, 11 and 15 and 37, 26 and 27. God said, I'm going to take the old nature out of you, the stony nature out of you, and I'm going to put a new nature in you, and then I'm going to give you a new nature, and then I'm going to put my spirit in you so you can walk by my law. See, under the old covenant, our Hebrew ancestors, they couldn't walk by faith and not by sight. They had to walk by the law. But the law was, the law got this. The law became L-E-G-A-L.
Legal.
Say amen. The law became legal. And so they lost the spiritual intent of what the word, what the Spirit of God was saying to them. And so it was only a tutor. Say tutor. You know, I don't know about y'all, but you know the Lord been tutoring me all my life. I don't know about y'all. Because I can't do nothing without, I don't know about y'all, but the kid can't do nothing right without God. And how many of you think you can do it? So the Lord said, I'm going to give you a new nature. I'm going to give you a new spirit. That new nature is not your flesh. Your flesh just does what it wants to do. When it's talking about the flesh, and it's talking about your sense. Your sense is see, hear, smell, taste, and feel. Amen? And it wants to do what it wants to. So that's how the devil got Adam and Eve in the beginning. He got Eve. And let me tell y'all, let's not blame the woman.
Right,
man. I said, woman, let's not.
Woman, yeah.
Man with a womb. Let's not blame the woman. Let's blame the man, the male man. Oh, y'all didn't get that.
Wow.
Because of the male man, Jerry. That's the reason why we have to deal with the things that we have to deal with today. Because the male man wasn't on his job. He wasn't delivering the mail that God gave him to deliver like he's supposed to.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Amen.
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 If he had been on his jail bed and watched a snake coming up talking to his woman, he would have put him in check. Oh, no, Papa, you're not coming up here talking to my woman? Forget that.
That's right.
He would have kicked him out of the garden. Oh, y'all.
Yeah,
what do you think I got? It's in the Bible. God said he created the man outside of the garden. Then he created the garden. Then he put the man in the garden. Watch this. And he told him to protect it. He told him to till it and to keep it. Till and to keep in Hebrew means guard and protect it from all outsiders and all your enemies. Okay. Satan creeped up in there in the form of a serpent, a flying serpent. Oh, y'all ain't gonna get that.
All right, go ahead.
And start talking to the man's woman. And Lord bless his heart. Adam was standing right there.
The whole time
while the snake is talking to his woman.
Alright.
So Jacob came. So the father prophesied. Say, prophesied. How many of you know that you are a prophetically speaking spirit person right now?
Yes.
How many believe? Don't you know you're a prophetically speaking person? Don't you know that every time you speak a word, it comes to pass?
Negative or positive.
All thank right. you, Kiana.
All right.
Yep.
Amen.
You the son told her what you've been saying, I'm going to use yesterday, today. Well, why is that, Dr. Clark? I'm glad you asked that question. Because we're created in God's image and likeness, and God does nothing without speaking. He creates when he speaks. Watch this. When you're allowing any kind of word to come into your thought life or in your mind, and you speak that word out, you're creating your own environment.
That's right.
Ain't got nothing to do with your color. I know this bad, it's bad colloquialism, Dr. Clark. Bad English. It has nothing to do with your color. It has nothing to do with your gender. Because in the spirit realm, in the supernatural, man is a spirit. Woo, 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 woo.
Woo, woo, woo.
And so when God created the man, why am I going there? Because the Lord taking me there. Because you got to understand where you were and where you are now and where you are going in order for you to build and go forward or keep it moving in your walk of Christian life. The devil not supposed to be whooping us coming out and going in. The Bible don't say that. The Bible says you're supposed to be blessed coming in and going out.
Yes, right.
Not being whooped coming in and going out.
Yeah, yeah, come on.
Help us now.
Right.
Did y'all get that?
That's right.
Yeah.
It's time for us to pick up. It's time for us to do a checkup from here up. It's time for us to scrutinize and examine the thoughts that come into your mindset or your thought life and say, I don't know if this comes from God or comes from the devil. Well, if you pick up this word, then you know what. I don't know what God is thinking. Yeah, you do. Quit lying. Repent. I'm not, I didn't call no names, did I?
No.
Hallelujah. So God's word of God starts to spread. When you speak word, you're expressing your thoughts. We don't have any original thought. Everything that is has already been. You think this technology that we enjoy now, this is the first time you think we're evolving forward? You know, we're evolving forward? No. We're going back to where we were because back in the day or earlier in the kingdom, when God first created man, even after the fall, it took them 930 years to get Adam to die. So the things that they built, the pyramids and all of that, it was technology then that we haven't even reached yet.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm just saying. I'm just talking loud. Okay. So what am I saying? The very fact that Jesus was raised from the dead, the firstborn from the dead, you are the second and the third and so on and so forth. We are born again. Jesus is our prototype, the prototype. So God used him. Guess what? God had you in mind before the foundation of the world for you to be successful in any area of your life. Your children, your grandchildren, all of your generations. But then we have an enemy who hates us. The devil hates us. But we don't have, as they say in Texas, we're not scared of him.
I'm right.
Okay. When it comes, you're supposed to tell him what the word. You're supposed to tell him it is written. It is said. It is written.
Right.
Where is it written at?
That's word.
And where else is it written? It's written on the scrolls in heaven. You have an immediate audience in the courts of heaven, 24/7. You ain't got to go in there. You ain't got to go in there and get and tell. Well, I got to. You know how you're doing it naturally. You got to have an appointment with your attorney. Wow. And then your attorney got to meet you. And then the attorney got to go in and talk to the judge before you can get in. You already got your attorney. Your attorney already made the way possible for you with his blood. All you got to do is walk on in the courtroom.
Yeah.
You already there. And oh, okay.
That's right.
I'm talking about finding your foundation. Like we're moving on. All right, look down in where it says Philippians 2:6-11. It says that the day will come when everyone will acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Thank
I told you
man.
Christ means the anointed one and his
anointing.
Says the same anointing,
that
was on the Jesus is on me.
It's
in me.
It
says on my mind.
It's on my mind.
Otherwise, the Bible lied, and the Bible don't lie. Because the Bible is not it. The Word is not it. The Word is a person. Don't you know that this written Word was spoken from the living Word before it was written? It couldn't have been written if it wasn't said by the living Word.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Amen. So in your everyday walk, I'm looking in the spirit realm. I know you're having problems. I know you're going through issues. I know you're having circumstances. But don't let the circumstances, don't you be under the circumstances. Let the circumstances be up under you.
I know that's right.
How do I know? Been that done. I'm 68 years old. I ain't dead.
I know that's
right. I said that last time. That means that I've been around the corner a few times. My generation, you said pat and turn. You know what pat and turn mean? Patting them feet and turning them corners. I've been around the block a few times. I'm going to laugh. I've been there. I don't know everything, but my spirit does. Don't you know your spirit knows everything? Your spirit is your knower. Because why? Because the spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead is in your spirit. And just like a husband and a wife are one in flesh, you and the spirit of God are one spirit.
Amen.
So everything he knows, he reveals it to you. Is that power? find new scripture to validate that, Dr. Clark. I'm glad you said that. It says, I have not seen, ear have not heard, nor enter to the heart of man the thing that God has prepared for those who love him. Well, it's talking about natural man. Natural man is never going to receive the spiritual things of God. Because they don't make what?
Sin.
Say that again. They don't make what?
Sin.
They don't make sin. But he said, but God has given us of his spirit, his Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, that we may know, say no.
No.
That we may know the thing that God has freely given to us. I want to know everything that he's told me in the kingdom.
Amen. Yes, Jesus.
I want to receive everything that he's told me about in the kingdom before I ever got here. Are y'all getting anything out of this?
Yes,
amen.
Sir.
Yes.
All right.
Good word.
All right. He said that one day we'll be, everyone will acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord. But if one waits to make his or her confession until forced to do so, now, you know, everybody who's not confessed that Jesus is Lord now, my sister, is one day when the master come back, all of those that didn't confess Jesus as their Lord, they're going to be some big 10-foot angel. You're going to bow down.
I know that's right.
You're going to confess that he's master.
That's right.
But then they're gonna have to be forced, Barry, to do that. I don't want to be forced. I bow down right now. I don't have a problem. You hear me, Jeanette? I bow down right now. I don't care.
That's right.
I'll bow right down and what? Y'all. I bow down and worship and confess. Now confess, I'm saying the same thing that Father said. What did Father say that about you? He said it in eternity because he had you in mind in eternity before he created anything. He had your salvation, your success, your prosperity. He had everything in the kingdom written with your name on it. Say, my name is on it.
My name is on it.
They had a gospel song out not long ago. Contemporary God said, put your name on it. Well, your name is already on it. You ain't got to put your name on it. But you have to take it personal. Say, take it personal. You got to take it personal. I don't want God to raise up no natural rocks to praise God in my place. I want to worship him as a rock inside of me.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me?
Yeah.
This is why we are promised eternal life only if we make the confession willingly in this life. Willingly. Say willingly.
Willingly.
In this life.
This life.
Now, let's go on. According to Acts 2:20 and 28, what did Jesus purchase with his blood? I'll give you that. He purchased eternal salvation for us.
Amen. Eternal salvation.
He purchased eternal salvation with his blood for your life.
Amen.
Are y'all getting bored yet?
No.
That's why when I come in here, I don't care who's playing, I don't care who's singing, I don't care who's ministering, I don't have a problem worshiping. I'm going to get mine.
Yeah.
Pastor Daniel, Pastor Patricia, they going to get theirs.
Yeah.
You need to enter in and get yours.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Get it. Get yours. Why? It's already up. And quit going to God. I was listening to the Lord this morning, 2 or 3 o'clock this morning, and the Lord said, tell the people, quit coming to me asking me for stuff what I've already given them. He said, tell them to take what's there. Oh, yeah, I didn't get that.
Amen.
That business is already up. Take it. Okay. How do you take it, Dr. Clark? You take it by faith.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
It's yours. Why are we going to go and ask God for something he's already given? You're going to go ahead and thank him. Faith thanks him that it's already done. Say it's already done. Faith says it's already mine. You ain't got to go beg your daddy for nothing. Do your kids have to come beg you?
No.
My mom was 86 years old. I go to my mom's house. I could walk right on in my mom's house. Bust right on in the refrigerator. First thing I said, Mama, what you got to eat? She said, go on in and get whatever you want. Well, that's what God is telling you. Come on in. Say, come on in.
Come on in.
He said, come on in and get whatever you want. That's what he was telling you this morning, daughter.
Yes, God.
He told you to enter on in his presence of his glory and take everything that you've been asking him for day and night. Glory to God.
Amen.
Is this good stuff?
Yes, it is.
All right, now watch this. Turn to your Bible to Ephesians 1 and 7. Reason why I haven't been having you turn, because I already know most of these scriptures. So I can just quote them to you. You can look them up on your own. Ephesians 1 and 7, when you have to say I have it. We move along, we're going to be done. It said, now watch this. It actually, let's go up to the third verse. Let's go to the second verse. Let me just break that down for you. So break it down.
Break it down.
Now watch this. He said, grace. Now grace. Have y'all got this? Can I erase this? Thank you. We're not going to do a dissertation on grace. They got enough of that on TV. Grace. It says grace and what else? You got your Bible? So look at the second verse. Ephesians 1 and 2, what it say? Grace what?
Peace.
Grace is Christ. It's Christ. That's God. He's God's grace to you. He's God's, say that word, favor. Say favor.
Favor.
Amen. Jesus, the Christ, the anointed one, is God's grace to you to do whatever you need to do to complete your assignment of the kingdom 24/7. You got grace all the time. Say, I got favor.
I got favor.
Let me go back up here. I said, the kids got favor. I don't know about y'all. Say, I got favor.
I got favor.
All the time.
All the time.
Say, I'm surrounded,
I'm surrounded.
By favor.
Going in.
And coming out.
Coming out.
And when the devil started bringing the pressure, then why don't you act like you got the favor? Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Psalms 5 and 12, he said, his favor surround me as a shield. Quit letting your shield down. You're supposed to have your shield up. But you know, in a war, when I was in the Vietnam era, don't you know if I didn't have what we call our armor on, our military armor on, don't you know the enemy can take you out? Let your shield out of faith down now and see on the devil start bombarding your mind. He'll bombard you so when you got so many thoughts coming in and out, you're like,
right.
You got to keep your armor on. And I said it before, put your armor on and don't take it off. You don't need the armor in heaven. You need the armor down here. That's God's armor. The devil don't know who's in there. He know all he knows is God's armor. He know he can't penetrate.
Amen.
This is your foundation, finding your foundation for life. You're supposed to be successful. We, you, us, wins. We're supposed to be successful every day in every area. Not sometimes, all the time. Say all the time.
The time.
You hear me, baby?
Yes, sir.
All the time, son. You're a born again believer.
Amen.
Act like it.
Yes, sir.
Because people are watching you. People you know, the Lord said, people that you know, that you have an influence in their life, they're watching you.
Amen.
Represent. You know how they say in the world, I'm repping.
Yeah,
I'm representing.
I'm 100.
Huh? Yeah. I'm repping. I'm representing.
Yep.
They say that in the college, I'm repping. Well, represent the kingdom.
Okay.
Amen.
Represent the kingdom, son. Because people are watching all of us. If you're born again, then live that life. I have to live it. I'm tempted just like everybody else here. I have to go through what y'all go through. Jesus had to go through it. Okay. Are you listening? Now watch it. He said, grace to you and peace. Peace comes from the word shalom. I'm not going to go into it. Shalom is a Hebrew word. Shalom means safety, wholeness, soundness, protection, prosperity, success. Nothing broken and nothing missing. Amen?
Amen.
Now, sometimes I do things repetitive because you don't always get it the first time. Right. In natural school, you got to go over it again and again. And then all of a sudden, you're like, oh, I got it clicked. And the answer to the problem was already there. Well, the answer to the problem that you face in life is already there. While you're trying to figure it out, God already worked it out. He's trying to reveal it to you. But you ain't listening to him. You're looking from the wrong sight. You're looking with the wrong eye. You're hearing with the wrong ears. You got to hear with your spirit.
Mm-hmm.
You got to renew your spiritual mind. You have a spiritual mind as well as a natural mind. Natural mind is for natural things. Your soul is the mind of your spirit. That's what has to be renewed. That's why, just like you feed your spirit on the word of God, you got to feed your mind on the word of God. Why? To renew it. To change how you think.
Right.
Yes,
right.
The Bible says, as a man or woman,
thinking,
so are they.
Yeah.
That word is that, thinking in the heart, but that word is not translated correctly. That word heart is in the mind, because you think in your mind. Mm-hmm. Say amen.
Amen.
You think in your mind, you doubt in your mind, but you believe, B-E-L-I-E-V-E, you believe in your heart, or the heart when it talks about then, you believe in your spirit. That's how you got saved. Well, you got to believe God in your foundation for life. You got to believe God with your spirit for everything. You got to say it with your mouth and believe it in your spirit. Well, Dr. Clark, how am I going to do that? You're going to do it with the faith that God gave you. You have God's faith. So I have God's faith to do whatever He said I can do. In the now.
In the now.
In the now, not tomorrow. When tomorrow get here, it'll still be now. Remember I said it before. We're not natural people having a supernatural experience. We're supernatural people having a what? A natural experience. We're in the world, but we're not of the world. The world should have no effect. Especially all these young, look at all these young folk in there.
Amen.
The world shouldn't have no effect on your life. They shouldn't be able to influence. You're supposed to have. And I'm going to tell you something. And I ain't talking about calling no name. Did you know that the world has more influence on the church than the church has on the world?
Yeah,
it sure does.
We dance like them. We walk like them. We talk like them. I'm not talking about I'm not talking about clothes. Everybody wears the same kind of clothes. But I'm talking about from within, from your character. Your character should be, when they see you, they shouldn't see you, they should see the Christ in you.
Amen. Yeah. All right.
Stay close up here. Boy, y'all done got quiet on the kid. Peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Now look at here. Let's go on down. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us. What comes after the word? What does the word has mean? Has mean already.
Already.
So it said, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has means He has already blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly place. So that means if He has already blessed you with everything that you need, then why?